It was beautiful. And yet. Meanwhile, Arazid's mother has been kind of like hiding in the background watching the fight. Oh, she is. I think, like, since Ollie was AWOL last session, I assumed that she was kind of like hanging back and asking Arazid's mum all these different questions about who she is and like if she's a supportive of their relationship, yada yada yada, which we could roleplay. I believe it was the end of Audra's turn. he's super dead. Like there's a big hole in his chest. Like, yeah. Chance. The remaining two have dropped their weapons. Is that your turn? You see a map on the table, pinned to the table with daggers. It is a map of the the whole southern Dolores region. There are lots of things written on it in a script that you cannot read. Fair enough. Yeah, you can roll initiative if you like, but I was basically just going to roll over to the next turn to see if Solas would attack the orc that had surrendered in front of him before ending things. On his turn, he is going to attempt to flee. And if no one will stop him, he will dash. Ugh. Yeah. Yeah, go for it. If you'd please roll initiative then. I will give you like a reaction. But hey, your turn is up next anyway, so. Oh, I don't think you selected your token first. You are not on right now. More or less, yeah. We know you've rolled initiative, we know you're up next. But his movement will end there anyway. He's not wearing armour, that's what this little icon on him is for. Yes. Are you speaking in Orcish, Goblinoid, Common? Fair enough. You don't feel it anymore, sibling. You don't feel it anymore, sibling. Then let's get out of here before those murderers decide to take us too. Please roll me a persuasion check. He will sink into your arms and sob. I don't know where I am. Sure, yeah. And I think with him being pacified, we will go out of initiative. I didn't have an icon for grappled, but lovingly, so you just got the web. So to set the stage, there is one person who has been knocked out. Several other bodies, one healthy warg, one surrendered warg rider, and Jarl. Okie dokie. The one that is still being ridden is going to, like, shy away from you. The goblin is kind of wanting to leave.
Imagine my blind flurry. I'm sorry. My friend is dead. We were together for many moons. This many.
And he kind of like skirts onto his bum and holds up all four of his paws.
We go do custom. We bury him now. Grrr.
The warg takes his goblin friend's like shirt in his mouth and begins to drag the corpse away and into the outside. Going on in this little nook over here. Oh, there's a flaming sphere there. I assume it disappears. Solas is wanting to check out this room. Right. Inside is a large oak desk, upon which you see a letter. There is a flight of stairs with a bunch of rubble piled at the bottom, and there is a stuffed beast of some form. You can investigate the creature in particular, or perceive the room as a whole. Or one then the other. Well, you notice that the beast is standing on a trapdoor. Please roll athletics. This owlbear is stuffed full of straw and is fairly easy to shove aside. Just checking your languages. Aha. But you have one of the right ones. This is in Draconic. Let me just show it to... Yeah, show it to everyone. It's a fun letter. Beautifully done, Em, thank you. Seems appropriate. What is Inqua up to? Matt, you there? Hello. On his body, you find a small straw effigy of a humanoid dragonoid creature that you have come to recognize as a representation of Azarkul. Let me just pull up the full notes. You also find a spell scroll of shield. And he does also have a morning star on him. More of a nighttime person. Yep, that is everything you find on the body. Okie dokie. And Ollie is hugging a crying hobgoblin. He goes limp. He seems to have fainted. Larilla Ironfen, Folkor. I'll get his ankles. You get the rest of him. You're gonna carry him. Yay. I can do that. She pulls out one of her axes, seemingly from nowhere. What's Arazid doing? Who are you? What do you want? Ugh. I've got green skin, and I'm slightly taller than I used to be. What more do you want to know? I don't know my name. They just called me Slug. Slugs are gross and icky, sticky and slimy. Yes, call me Snail. Well, it was a few years ago now. We've been training in the mountains. Mountains far to the east. First, I was sold into slavery. I used to be a gnome. I think maybe a dwarf. I made pretty things. But then I couldn't pay my rent, and I was evicted and sold to pay off my debt. I was bought and sold again, and then I was blindfolded and strapped to an altar, and a priest stood above me with a dagger. I woke up then. Again on the altar, and my chest was sore, and my skin was green. And there was an echoing in my head. His voice playing over and over. I can still hear it. It's coming from upstairs. Upstairs, over there. Yes. And with 10 minutes having passed, Chance is able to decipher the map. Would you like to see it? Okay. So we'll have two versions. Fair enough, fair enough. So it says that on day 5, the horde as a whole will attack Own, and the whole horde isn't here, from what Solas found with the letter. No, the opposite way around. We're not even on day 5 yet. Yes. Nice. And I believe a lot of people are heading upstairs. You would emerge here. On the table before you, you see a piece of parchment that is blank except for the blood marks, like fingerprints made of blood. That dot across it. There is also a fetish, also made of straw, seemingly of Azarkul, or possibly of Anazid. Roll an arcana check. This certainly smacks of necromancy. Or other dark magic. Each fingerprint seems to have been made by a different finger. You would surmise that this is somehow a focal point for Azarkul's mind control shenanigans. could roll an arcana check to examine the surroundings better. You are suspicious that burning it may mean the deaths of all of the individuals whose blood are on the parchment. From what you can tell, Inqua, the effigy is kind of the prism of the magic. So if it were to be destroyed, it would have a lot of a safer outcome. Effigy burns away. You don't hear any screams of pain. You get one piece of parchment with random bloodstains on it. Those are windows. Yeah, that's fair. This floor is completely open to the elements. The roof has been ripped off by possibly a siege catapult, possibly the wind. A figure looks like a scarecrow at first, but as you get closer you realise that it is a rotting corpse of a human, possibly a farmer, that has been strapped onto a stand. Well, a history check, or no, a religion check. It is not a normal method of burial. Sure. Roll me a perception check, please, as you are looking at this thing. Yes. You are relieved to learn that you do not recognize this individual. There seem to be, like, there are, like, little bits of pillars around indicating that once there were more levels above this one, but the tower ends here. And then the ladder's a kind of testament to what used to be. Yeah, the ropes affix him to, like, a wooden, well, cross, essentially. The corpse is freed. Okay. You want to make a little stone cairn? Or just let the guy down? Working together, it doesn't take you much time at all to create a respectful little cairn for this unnamed farmer. Yeah. Oh, yeah. The cause of and solution to all of tech problems. It's only two floors, so, like, it's been about 30 seconds up and down. About an extra... You've spent, I'd say, about 2 minutes on the altar floor and then about 4 minutes on the top floor. So it's been about 7 minutes total. Oh, cool. Nice. and I will once again direct your attention to the area on the left of the screen as you climb down through a 5 foot deep vertical shaft and find yourself in a small underground area with three alcoves, each of which is sealed by a rusted old iron gate. No. To be honest, I should have chosen better stuff for this. So this alcove here has shelves on it with about 10 small boxes, coffers. This one here has a small desk and chair, and this one does actually have a chest. The skeleton is dressed in a tattered chainmail and is grasping a sparkling bastard sword. It has a massive arrow protruding out of its chest. It certainly looks special. It is glowing and cold to the touch. You may. Ooh, baby, there might be something magical about this sword. That is correct. They are a simple swing open door and they are locked. Ooh. Okay, so you can freeze the, like, the water in the air inside the lock. Do you want to... You would require, like, an external hit, like a kick or a weapon attack or something, to finish it off. They are, yes, they are quite empty and dry now. Please roll me an attack with the dagger. That's a hit, and the door is forced open. It swings inwards and smacks into the wall. Roll me that thieves' tools check. Yeah, both of you go for it. For the love of books, Inqua is able to pop the lock open very easily, only to be disappointed to discover that all of the books and papers piled on the desk within are rotted, and nothing but dust and nests for woodlice. He did succeed. From some of the titles on, like, the leather outers of the books, they looked fairly interesting. A lot of books on, like, military strategy and metalworking and stuff like that, but unfortunately unreadable. Chance finds a large trunk inside. I assume Audra is looting the first alcove now, by the way. Yes, so I'll go smallest to biggest. In one chest you find a deed to this castle. In three more you find a collection of notes of credit or bearer bonds made out to the Bank of Ornox. Roll a history check. Ornox is an old name for Own. It was changed approximately 300 years ago when Ornox's ruler, Rajat, disappeared, and his apprentice, Abalak Ray, took his place. Yes, that is likely. But in the remaining six, in total, you find 2,500 silver pieces, 2,100 gold pieces, and 120 platinum pieces. They are regular Southern Delore. Oh. I'm mixed up on the bracketing for that, but you get the drift. And Chance, you want to open that chest? inside you find the skull of a dragon, a necklace made out of 24 or so giant's teeth on string, a glittering chain shirt, a very dangerous looking spiked gauntlet, and a staff. You can try vibes check. Arcana. Inqua's voice rings in your mind and possibly also your ears. Stop touching things.
Hmm.
go for it. A slightly more valiant effort. You don't get bad touch vibes from anything in here, except you suspect, based on some of the darkness of the scales left on the skull, that there was some inherent evil about the dragon that owned it. Nice. Ah, oh, please somebody donate 6 to him. Yeah. I can buy like what, 1 banana? If you were to be shown them chance, you would recognize them from a past name and past heist. The same type of document. I mean, it's the document functions the same as the ones you found in Jurass. Interesting. The ones for that you are holding appear a lot more used, crinkled, well traveled, but the design appears to be the same. You wonder if perhaps the same calligrapher was responsible for making these. He certainly thinks he could try. You do notice at the bottom there is a serial number written onto each sheet of paper, so you while you would be able to turn the word Ornox into Jurass, possibly, the serial number may cause an issue. he's kind of like curled up and like kicking. Ah, they are for 5,000 gold each. Well, you assume so. If, I mean, you could try and forge it for the bank over on Alembo. Yeah. Bridge. Yeah. You could history check me. yeah. I mean, you can't really hurt her. Oh, Audra. You don't believe Rendian is real. two max. Oh, lonely mortal, it has been 1.5. I think Chance was there for like the rematch. And while you're pondering, you can do me a swifty little advantage survival check. You have no frame of reference for like the scale of this map, so it does make it harder to examine. It could be half a day's march, it could be like 2 or so days travel. Unless you bring Solas. Are you guys bringing this conversation upstairs where Ollie can vote in as well? It is kind of difficult to get this chest up, this like vertical shaft that leads up to the ground floor, but... Oh yeah, that'd work. Keep forgetting you can do that. Okay, eventually you... I'll say that in your absence it appears that that Mama Folkor has begun to move some of the bodies. Nah! Fuck that! They were just throwing off the feng shui! Did you see how much that you get, Ollie? Yeah. Cool. Yeah. You've got a very sensitive fanny pack. You've just never felt whole. That's why. Yeah. Oh yeah. Okie dokie. Oh yeah. You could just call her Ray. Just a quick question. Is Inqua getting a head start on identifying stuff? Cool. You identify the sword. Yeah, so the only items that are magical in there are the chain shirts, the gauntlets, and the staff. The chain shirt is a plus one mithril chain shirt. The gauntlet is a spiked gauntlet used by brawlers. And the staff is... I'm just gonna show only Inqua. No, he'll get white uh-oh. Oh yeah, of course it doesn't pop up if I just show it to one. Flower stuff. Oh, that was fun. It would be nice for a flower staff, wouldn't it? It's a fear staff. I don't know if Inqua would like to summarize his findings. I mean, what is the spell called? I don't know if it's popped up for you guys, but I just shared the staff with the rest. I mean, we have things like Melf's Acid Arrow and Liamon's Tiny Hut and Mordekainen's Magnificent Mansion. Yes! Oh, no, I just forgot about druids. Of course, they could do it too. No. No. Technically not. Or could they? Yeah, a druid could. So that was druid erasure. He's making like very, very slight whimpers in his sleep, like not me.
Excuse me, chance, right? If you need on a limbo, I've never been there, but you can write a letter. Aye? You know your letters. I could deliver it. If you send me ahead of everyone else.
You're not quite sure who that is anymore. It was Tian. But there was some, I guess, a voting. You guys kind of introduced democracy there just before you left. And also he, like, might be getting thrown out of his position anyway. And one to Emoja, maybe. Or just one to... Or one letter to the Council of Three. Damp. Yeah, a short one. Like an hour. I mean, you definitely will be resting for at least 40 minutes while Inqua does his identifies. And Chance could also write a letter in that time. Yeah. I'd appreciate it if you could write me something substantial that I could work off of for the Onilembo crew. But from what I understand, you guys are going to the bridge first? A black ray first. So, but all in all, you don't need to have this message done now because you guys aren't immediately about to go to Onilembo, so no rush. Yeah. I am assuming that Arazid would also like to roll some hit dice. Yeah, there we are. Oh, nice. Pfft. Oh my god! Bro! A game once called 999. Yes. Temporarily. Fucking A. No more dog Nio then. Not like we saw him much anyway. It was a bit of a rough deal. Hey, not as rough of a deal as a Nio got. Yeah. In that case, you don't need to spend like 2 hours removing this and then attuning. So do you want to attune to, what did you call it, merciful rhyme flame? How'd you get merciful? Ah. Fair enough. I didn't know what rhyme flame was, but I googled it and now I get it completely. Good choice of name. Fair. I mean, I still prefer cold death because that's what I came up with, but Solas absolutely will attune to his new rhyme flame. Chance is going to write a letter, a couple of other people are resting, we're going to have a 10-minute break here. Ooh. Yep, see you in 10. Alright, where did we leave off? You guys were having a little long rest, doing your various attunement things. Short rest, my apologies. I just read a message with the word long in it. So you regain hit dice. Or hit points, I should say. Solas now has a cool new weapon. And the letter will be complete. And it seems that Arazid's mother is ready and willing to be the messenger. She will give you a squeeze, she will lift you off of your feet. No. It's not going to be forever. I'll be back with an army. And until then, just fiddle on this and remember me. And she touches the braid that she did for you yesterday. Be strong, my little prince. And with a message she can respond, right? Oh, right. Okay. Aye. So who am I looking for? Oh. Yeah. Look for big, shiny, big, important buildings. If all comes to bad, ask for whoever's in charge. I think I'm ready. Whew. I will not fail you. Oh, all righty. Well, nice to meet y'all. Oh yes, alright. Portal time, here we go. Ooh. Oh, you're a strong lassie. Yes. Wait, what? Pregnancy? Do you, like, push her into the portal, or...? She's, like, walking forwards and looking backwards. And she kind of falls down through the portal and disappears with a surprised look on her face. Imagine if there were two. What do you mean, who knows? I'm pretty sure they haven't. You finally leave Wrathkeep behind for now. There you go. And who's going to the palace again? Goodness, why are you all different sizes? Okay, it's probably about the same. Yeah. Yeah. I figured we could just do this instead of have one. Okay. I see you guys stroll up to the gates. There is a skeleton crew manning it. Do you have an appointment? Let me see. The skeleton takes out a clipboard. Yes. You have an appointment. Go right in. Go straight forward up the stairs. You will get directly to the throne room. If you want to. Okay, so you guys are waiting where, sorry? Just outside the throne room. Cool. You climb up the stairs and it is an almost like straight and unbroken pathway deeper and deeper into this pyramid. You're following it for quite a while and eventually reach a pair of doors where the corridor opens up. Rise. into my domain. Yes. Why should I do that? By this point, you have no doubt seen what I make my army out of. Tell me, what would I gain by saving people that could be my subjects? I am Abalakre, the Queen of the Dead. I find it funny that one who travels in the company that you do would lecture me on who I keep half of my company in. You travel with criminals of own. Strategically left them outside. And your friends owe me an undead army. And your friends owe me an undead army. If it were not for their actions, then I would have more than enough forces to destroy Azarkul here and now. I don't want to, because I can just harvest the battlefields afterwards, follow in their wake, free army for myself. I could have been more inclined. Perhaps if you bring something for me, I will think of helping you.
matters.
Yeah, you can roll a history check. Nope. Not something you've heard of. Like, there's an oasis that you've heard of called, like, the Oasis of Black Waters. But, like, that's the only thing that you can think of right now.
I came and found your friends in my search for it, and it has since disappeared into the sands of time. Find me an alternative source. I'm sure someone knows where it is, and I could defeat Kull. It is a curse. It withers and kills people and allows them to be resurrected. Oh, that much sweeter and easier. It is a way of cursing water to produce unlimited undead. Several of them have even since added to my army. I sense that as of a few hours ago, maybe even a few more will join them. Come find me here again. Farewell. Ah, yes. Very well.
And you're able to exit and return to own. Okay. You kind of cut off there, Sarah. And it's like 2 p.m. ish now. One of them. Some good people. Da, 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 da. So you leave the city, and what kind of pace are we keeping up here? Okay. That sounds like her. Yeah. I'm picturing that, like, that really weird flag with, like, a face with three legs on it. Yeah, I mean, fair. You never did. Is that like your collective, the collective name of adventurers, the consequences? What about Sunny's friends? Look, Chance didn't go to school. Oh, good lord. Cool. And so otherwise, you are marching towards the bridge at a fast pace. Yeah. With a fast march, you are able to get there at sunset. Yeah, the gorge is lined with obsidian, and so it sparkles like a black void, and though old and slightly crumbly in places, it is a pretty thick-looking stone bridge. What is your plan of approach? Yeah, roll me a perception check. It very well may do. Yep, there are some people there. Yep, you also spy hobgoblin guards. Yeah, I imagined a meat board as well. Chartreuserie? Yeah. I've never known quite how to pronounce it, is all. And no matter how any of us pronounce it, anyone who speaks French will be like, hoo, hoo, hoo. The snackle, yes! No, the gorge is far too deep for there to be supports, like, midway. It's one of those bridges that, like, there are some supports originating from each edge of the cliff. Like an L bracket. Your mic's doing that thing again, Sarah. Yeah, you, I've placed your tokens down here, but that's, you know, you guys can approach from any angle that you like, so I imagine that you could come in from, like, more of a this-way angle or the reverse and be able to see a lot without being necessarily perceived. Yeah, and pass without trace, which is also useful. Rolling a stealth check as he does so. Nice. Once you descend into the gorge, you notice movement. Clinging to the wall of the cavern opposite. Well disguised, but just noticeable. Is a dragon. Which you may be able to see now. Please. I'm gonna just roll something off screen as well. You don't believe it's seen you, no. Yep, so you're about like 10 feet kind of down below the edge of the cliff right now. So the support itself is like an inverted L, where like one side of the L is attached to the underside of the bridge and the other side is up against the cliff face. So there's, apart from like the occasional like flattish rocky outcrop, there's nowhere really to stand. The supports are 5 feet across, but, you know, vertically. Yeah. You've not been paying much attention to the dragon as you like approach the supports, and when you draw this rune, you feel like the air inside this cavern change, and the dragon flaps its wings once, twice, and roars. From the from the camp on the other side of the chasm, you can hear, "Oi, get up! I think we got something!" But you are able to stone shape this support off. It's not by itself enough to ruin the bridge. Okay, so I think that's everyone. Nicely done. Chance. Yes. So you've used 15 feet of movement. Yeah, that's just gonna straight up do it, really. Now let's go for a oh, 10-foot cube. The section that you disintegrate falls away, and the rest of the bridge begins to crack, and it falls down until, at the other end, it also cracks, and the supports are just holding the other end of the bridge up, but instead of it now being level, here it's at ground level, and then when it reaches the other side of the chasm, it's pointing about 30 feet down. I mean, as it is now, the bridge looks unusable, especially for an army. Yeah. This hobgoblin is gonna run over to the edge, see what they can see. They see Chance, and they are going to attempt to great bow you out of the sky. Nice. Clutch. As its bonus action, it's gonna shout out, "Over here! Over here! Intruders!" Arazid. Yeah, I think you're right. Yeah, you've shot things from further away than that before. Okay. Miss. Hit. You do some damage to it. No, 10 doesn't kill a dragon, no. Alright, Arazid running. You can hear a lot of shouting. In Orcish this time, or possibly Goblinoid, you're not entirely sure. No one here speaks that language, I think. Cool. They seem to be shouting across the chasm very hurriedly and panickedly. Ollie. with a hit. Beautiful. Is that your turn? Okay. This one's gonna lean on the edge, look out and see if it can see anyone. It sees Arazid trying to flee, so it's gonna shoot at Arazid. But I don't think either of those hit. Oh boy. Maybe you should get that chain shirt. That plus one chain shirt or something. Well, you take 4 piercing damage as a quite large arrow sinks into your calf. You hear more panicking and running around from the camp on the other side. This guy over here is going to shoot at Chance as well, but can't hit such a small moving target. Inqua. Is who wearing metal armor, sorry? Yes. Yes. They are mostly wearing plate. Well, you could take the chain shirt. Someone should take the chain shirt. Well, it fails either way. Yep. If it's in physical contact, it just takes that damage. Is that 15 overall? So it has disadvantages on attacks and checks. If it doesn't drop it. Yeah. Especially plate. Oh boy. Is that your turning call? Go for it, Solas. The walls are 30 feet high. Yeah, I believe so. +3 plus strength modifier. Nice. Yep, that would be an athletics check. Spider Solas. Well, this guy's definitely noticed that. He's running right up and he's going to fire once at Chance and once at Solas in that order. Does the 24 hit Solas? Oh. 8 damage? Audra. Earthbind, alright. Fair enough. So strength save with the DC of 20. Strength save again. It was not meant to be. This dragon gonna fly over here. Is gonna look at you guys. And is going to breath weapon Chance, Ollie, and Inqua. The note is still stuck in it. It's got little stubby T-Rex wings. I think it's coming for you regardless. Nice. Okay, so all three of you take half damage of... Yes. Half of half, yeah. So you take... I swear it was half damage. No, I mean that, I thought it just halved whatever damage that you ended up taking. Oh, is that uncanny dodge? Yes. Yep, so those who took damage take 11 damage. Wait. No, 21 damage, sorry. Yep. It is then going to fly closer to the bridge. The panicking from the other side continue. Chance. The Kleenex escape. All right. This hobgoblin is going to drop its bow and take out its sword, for which it has disadvantage to hit since it is wearing some very spicy metal right now. And I'm assuming not hits on Solas. Yeah. 18s. With the 22 or 25 of hit. Nice. Arazid, continue to flee. Okay. You've got a couple of targets. Archer A or Archer B. You can't quite see the dragon from your angle. And I think that the other guys are a bit further out for you. Yep. Yee. Hunter's Mark. I'm gonna go ahead and roll the attacks. No hits. Or not. No, yet, no hits. You run 25 feet off screen. Ollie. That is a hit. You feel fairly well hidden underneath Grandpa. Well, this one's got no better target than Solas, so it's going to shoot at you. No hits. People seem to be moving on the other side, and this hobgoblin can only see Inqua and Solas. But one poses a much greater threat right now, so Solas. You are pierced for 12. Inqua. Yes. 2d8. Yeah, he takes some damage. Yeah. Alright. Hit him, you do. You still hit. Yeah. Nice. Is that your turn? Silas. Nice. That hits. Okay. What is he better at? Well, yes. I mean, chance you're really like trying here, but the dice just not in your favor today. Oh, right, take the lower. Right, so status quo continues, the status of him not being pushed off the tower. Anything else that you can do? Does he want to run? sounds good. Yep. You wouldn't be able to be targeted by anyone who wasn't... who wouldn't be able to see within the confines of this wall. I mean, he'd be able to hit you with advantage. Oh yeah. So it works out. Well, now this hobgoblin can't see anyone, so it's not going to attack. Audra. Should be in here. Right now I can't even find a maybe a fairy? Just trying to find a token. It's got to be somewhere you can see, and you wouldn't be able to see, that would work. Okay, I found some- ugh! Fucking non-transparent backgrounds. Okay, can I shrink you? Can't really shrink you. Can I shrink you? Wait, how big are pixies? Yeah, those work. Okay, so pixies. That would be a small, I assume. I swear I'm spelling it right, right? P-I-X-I-E. It's not in the Roll 20 compendium. Yeah, and if you don't mind, just like when you need to roll for them, just doing it with like a manual dice roll. Right. Okay, so they are tiny. So I'm gonna use two of them to represent eight of them. Oh my god, they have one health. Yeah, alright. Cool. Eight wisdom saves. What is it going to be polymorphed into, just out of curiosity? Badger will fuck you up. Oh. Yeah. Well, because here's the thing, it has this too. So it would have done that of the first. Yeah. But at that point, I just wanted to see if it would have been able to scrape by. Yep. So, yeah, two of the pixies didn't cast anything. I'm gonna roll them anyway. And how much does a badger have again? Okay, so 74. It would take in dragon form. I mean, you feel pretty optimistic. The dragon certainly disappears. You can't quite tell if that's because it's just like very camouflaged now or what, but... Over, yeah, okay. Yeah. Unfortunately, they are also slightly out of range. The pixie needs to move 10 feet to be in range. Alright, okay. In that case, sleep will be cast. 5d8 with a 20 feet point that you choose within range. Oh, so you probably could have. Unfortunately, since these guys are pretty fresh to the battle, and haven't, yeah, nobody gets knocked out the first time, but with the second roll. Oh, okay. Who, sorry? Ah, okay. Cool. He unfortunately does not fall asleep either. Oh, nice. Awesome. You hear a roar of pain coming from deep within the chasm. It echoes out thanks to the walls. But you see nothing else. Chance. Mm-hmm. You can indeed. This will drop your invisibility. Oh, nice. Ah, I see. I believe so. Yep. He certainly is looking pretty hurt. Yeah. Again. This one's going to be continued to be hecked off towards Solas, and I think that now misses. Yep. Arazid. Yep. You can try. Yes. Oh, and at the end of its turn, it took how much more damage from Inqua's acid arrow? Nice. Right, sorry for interrupting, Arazid. Nar. Yar! 9 damage and the hunter's mark. Nice. No. It looks bloodied. More action is happening over on the other side of the bridge. Ollie. Thank you. Yes. You think that the dragon's in there somewhere and you're trying to hit at it. I mean, it's not, it doesn't technically have cover. I can't wait to see this. It's gorge. Yep, yeah, okay, 25. You follow the track of your arrow, bolt, as it descends into the darkness, and you hear another howl, or growl, I should say. You don't... Oh, yeah. I do hope you leveled up. I haven't checked in the last week. Okay, just write that down there to level yourself up soon. And yep. And your message laden arrow apparently sinks into this creature and you just hear it go. Way below, you can just about make out its corpse on the floor of the chasm. Well, yeah. From this angle, this guy's got the pick of the litter, more or less. So he's going to attempt to hit Inqua. Did you say both hit? Wamp wamp. He's got plot armor. Inqua just identified plus one scale mail. It's up to, look, he's old. It's up to him if he wants to wear armor or hasten his death. So Inqua takes 18 damage. You see that on the other side, people are like, they're gathering, ropes and planks, and they seem to be now like standing on like the edge of the chasm, talking amongst themselves in animated orcish. But the ones with the bows also can't see anyone anymore, so aren't going to make a turn, so it's Inqua's turn. Yep. 14's a lot of damage. You're not... Like, I can't delve deep into it in the middle of initiative because that would require a roll, actually. But it would certainly collapse under an army's weight, you know that. And also it can't reach onto the other side anymore. Says Chance's voice from thinner. Yep. It's a hit and a damage. Solas. First you stand up and use up half your movement speed. You think you might want to... So, yeah, so this guy has a plus 9. Yeah. Does a 25 hit as a AOO? Oh. Oh no. You couldn't just take the 10! Oh, okay. I see. Well, that was just unnecessary. It's more like a cloud of pixies. I hope you can see that there is like a staircase on each of the towers that like goes halfway down. So you scale halfway, like, well, about a third of the way down it, and then walk across the stairs and like climb down the edge of the stairs for the rest. That's fair. It's not always obvious. Cool. I'm assuming everyone else has now like fled far away enough that they wouldn't be on the map. Okay. Okay. Next round will... Yeah. It's only been one round. Cool. Okay. Nice. But out of you three guys, are you all still on the edge of the map too, or...? Cool. I mean, yeah, that hobgoblin's still not gonna have a target. Audra. Okay, like, I will say now that the wording of the spell that I think you're trying to dispel, like, are you trying to turn them not into orcs anymore, or are you trying to, like, break their mind control? I've had you rolled for that, with the things that, like, make up a manazid, but that is a different... Right, yeah, that was when you didn't know what it was that was doing it. I'm going to point out, now that you guys do know what caused it, the wording of the spell isn't reversible. Yeah, yeah. I mean, you don't know what that is, so you can give it a go. Yeah, yeah, you can target any of the Hujima flips. Sure, what's the range on that again? Ah, nice, so more than enough to reach across the chasm. Yeah, they are going to need to roll. Thanks. Yeah, they have... Oh, plus two to the... Narp. Yarp. So out of that, there are potentially two successes. Oh no, make that three successes. Cool. So some of them seem to be staggering around a little bit, like their loyalties are a little divided, their brains are a little fuzzy. Anything else? Yeah. Fair enough. Fair enough. So the next up is one of the people who was apparently cured by this. And he just takes a step back and another step back, and he bashes into one of the ones who was not liberated. They growl something at one another, and then this guy appears to freeze once more. Chance. Arazid? Well. A wise choice. I think at this point you're probably the furthest away out from the map area. This other hobgoblin is going to similarly turn tail and try and run, and is given the same dressing down. This one, who is not encumbered, appears to be able to flee. Ollie. All right. this last hobgoblin can't see Solas. Arazid, Ollie aren't there. Audra and Inqua are there? Oh, God damn it, I closed the sheet by accident. so it's going to hit. Try and hit once at each of you, Audra and then Inqua. Okay, Inqua. As is yawning and fleeing. Well, no, fleeing costs movement. Flee? Cool. Solas. Flee? Ooh. This fight. Who was that, sorry? Aha, okay. Unfortunately not, but there's this one brick in the wall beneath that looks really funky right now. Yeah. You may have just invented disco, who knows? Is that your turn? Audra. You'd hope not. It would be very pathetic, very sad to be super intelligent and then also trapped in the body that you couldn't control. Yeah. Okay. Nice. That does like quite a big area, if I recall. 20-foot square. it's first level. Strength saving throw for the three of them. Two failures. Oh no, what's the... Right, 12 you said. Right. Yeah, fair enough. Alrighty. Double entangle. Quantum entanglement. Another round of all saves. Are we going to do this for all eight? One is tangled. Oh wait, I can stop rolling for one of those now. Okay. So that's one, two, three, four. So we've got four casts left. Cast five. Cast six. Seven. Eight. Oh well. Yeah, bridges have reasons for existing, don't they? Well, I think that the end of Audra's turn, I think, is once again a great place to end the session.